Yeah, overall, of course, losing a game or not winning another one, depending how you see it. We have to admit it's a difficult moment for us. So of course it's a difficult moment because we don't in the league for quite some time haven't won, and it's obvious to see the players. Even if you see the game today, we come out, the players, great attitude, good performance, first half an hour dominating against a very good side, Tottenham, have a good couple of good chances, really good shots from Boney, and first time they arrive they score. Of course, in a team who's already struggling, winning in the league, that hurts even more. So, but I don't think there's so much we can do. The only ones who can change this is ourselves. And the way we can change this is by winning a game in the league. I know we won it at Old Trafford in a couple of weeks ago, but as you mentioned yourself, that was in another competition. So it's not that it's not counting, but it's... Unfortunately, it doesn't count as points in this competition that we just see today. So it's really about... It's understandable, the players, they're a little head down right now in the dressing room, which is understandable. And it's, of course, always after a game you lose, it's difficult to find, even as a player, to find some positive things. But we have to see it this way, that... There's a lot of other teams in our situation, at least with the points. So we have to see. We can go out now and win one or two games, better two than one, of course, in the next coming games. It will change. First of all, of course, it will change the number of points. It will change even the difference to some teams in the table. But it will give the whole team that confidence. I said before the game that in nearly all the games I've seen a lot of confidence in the play from the players. I haven't seen players afraid of playing. It was the same today. I haven't seen players who are afraid to play. But of course, as a team, when you're struggling in terms of results and of wins, you do well, you draw. You do well, you lose. You do well, and you lose again. Then at a certain stage, it does hurt, and that's why the only medicine right now is it's only one thing, is that's to win a game in the league. And I say in the league because as you mentioned as well, the next coming game will be a cup game, and I hope to win that as well. But it will not give us 3 points. It will give us a pass to a next round, which is great as well, and we will try to do everything to win that game, but it's a different competition. And said that after that, of course, a part of the game in today is quite a good example for a team like us right now in our situation. We're dominating, we have a chance, it's post or crossbar and out instead of crossbar and in. And it's the same little with the injuries, you know, and especially, you never want an injury, but and in this moment, we didn't want anyone. We want people to come back. And instead, today, we lost another one. We don't know how bad it is, but that's typical as well when you, at least, you needed another injury. And I repeat, you never need injuries, but I hope you understand what I mean, and you pick up another one. But let's see what happens in the coming week with players like Michel, De Guzman, Pablo, even Nathan Dyer. And let's see what's for the next game. I have to repeat it all?
No.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Thank you. Well, I always say the same. Nearly. Almost.
Michael, when you look at the next four league games, could they be the key to the season because you're playing teams around you in those next four matches?
Yeah, I think so. I think if we see right now, there's a game tomorrow, West Brom, but they can maximum go to 24. So tomorrow, after this round, will be the 22nd. There will be 6 points from number 10 to number 20. That means 11 teams in 6 points. And we, in the next six games, we play five of these. We play Fulham at home, the next one. Then we go West Ham, play Cardiff here, Stoke away. Then we have Liverpool, it's a little different. And then I think Crystal Palace now. So next six, we'll have five direct opponents. That as well will mean after the Crystal Palace, I think there will be 10 games left. And I think for the next, more or less, those five or six games, most of these teams, these 11 teams, will be there more or less. Then maybe after the next six games, a couple of teams will have gone away. And the rest will probably have to compete for the last remaining 10 games. So, referring to what you're asking, I totally agree. The next four or maybe six games will decide if we have to suffer until the 11th of May, or that if we could look not safe, because you can't be safe unless you win all six or five or six, but at least with a certain distance in terms of points, because having that many teams, they have to play each other as well. You know, they can't, if they play each other, they can't have 3 points, both of them, no. So those are key games, and I think especially the next four, because they just come in 2 weeks now. It's Tuesday, Saturday, Saturday, Tuesday, or something like that, more or less. So there'll be those four games in 2 weeks.
Shelby, was his hamstring
working there? Yeah, it's been a little tight, you know, for 10 days. Which is normal again. We're talking a young player not used to play all the time, and suddenly he plays all the time. And it's always a balance. Should you take him out? The other day, last week, he had a little bit as well. I took him off, but again, he's an important player for us. He's shown he's an important player for us. So it's always, it's a balance. Huh? I take him out at halftime today, you probably all kill me here. So say, why did you do that? But
yeah, it's options on the bench, aren't you, at the moment?
No, we are a little short in some areas of position of the pitch, and especially in midfield right now, we were quite short. Jordi has played two games now there, but that's what I have to accept. We have to accept right now, and. It's normal right now. To everything is just black, you know. Everything is negative, and you lose players. Do they come back next week? Not. And let's start again tomorrow or the day after tomorrow. We look forward next, and then see if we can recover some players, and again try to get that into the team. That it's a matter of a win, and it. There's a lot of teams in our situation, so even if it seems like it's a dark, very difficult moment for us, then we can look at the others and say, well, they're all there. So with just a little more, luck, but a little more luck in certain situation maybe, and to get that goal that could change the game and win that game. It's what we have to focus at.
Do you think it was a penalty on the push on Bowman?
I don't know. I don't know. I was more focused on the things we did and in the first 25-30 minutes. And but again, as you asking me now as well, I knew as well, if we don't score when we are doing well, especially in right now in our situation, then it can happen what happened. Now it happened in the first time they had a shot on target. It could have had maybe like the other day, 2 minutes into the second half. So when I talk about luck, it's not luck about flipping a coin or something. I talk a luck of that to get that goal in the right moment. If you remember the last game we won in the league against Newcastle. I mean, we had that luck. We played well, and then we got that goal in a moment where we played without forwards just before half time, and then second half was different, and then we scored in a couple of counter attacks and we won the game. It's something about that that I hope we will just get in a game. So, because I know it's not much we need to turn things around, because it's if we're playing really poor the whole time, then it would be more difficult. Or if I saw three or four players in the start 11 a little worried about having the ball or not asking for the ball, then it would be a much greater job. Now it's only, and I say only, to win a game.
But do you not think there was periods of that in the second half? Perhaps not people not wanting the ball, but a lack of confidence.
Yeah, of course. That's why I'm talking about the general confidence. When you do well, you don't score. They see a goal, then you just have a reaction there. 5-10 minutes where they could even have scored a second one. I think they had a one they shot high, and then after the third goal, yes, I agree. But it's. In a certain way, you understand what is going through their head, and especially if you have played. But it's really a matter of frustration that you want to, but you can't. And you know, inside, you know when you're three down, you know the game is over. But you just have to move on. That's why, I mean, that first goal, we know it's so important. We know it's important in most of the games. And we just hope that we will... In these coming games, we will get that first goal, so I'm sure it will turn that part as well.
Michael, looking at the end of the rest of this month now, and people coming in possibly, has there been any contact with Manchester United about Wilfried Zaha?
No.
Have you made any progress, Michael, transfer-wise?
I don't know. I don't know what to say to you. I know the club is working, but. I don't know what stage.
Rich Williams, well, Michael, the newest name on there.
Well, again, one more name added to a player who can play different positions. But again, two things. I don't think it's a use me talking about players who are not here on rumor basis. And two, I think again, the most important players are the ones that are here. And even more now in this moment. So, and on the other hand, you just getting a player two in or three or whatever it is. That is not the only solution. You know, you can't think that just because you get one or two or three players in, then that will change. No, it is. Things will only change in our. I can't speak for other teams there, but for our team is to win. A game, or maybe two games in out of three, that would give it that boost that we need.
Given the situation you're in, Michael, and the injuries that you've got, is this the most challenging time that you've had, presumably that you've had here? How much?
Yeah, of course it is, because last year part of three losses in the beginning. Even in the end, where we lost more games, quite some games. We were already safe, you know, with more than 40 points and a trophy up in the closet up there, you know. So it was different, but not only for me. I think for the club, for the team as well. I think I mentioned it more times that this is a club and a team. Been used to the thing has, it's always going good, going well, more or less. And I say it's. I think I said it the other day at the press conference that when you're at the highest level, you need to suffer sometimes. There are clubs that are suffering every year. At the bottom, sometimes they save themselves the last round or three rounds to the end, or sometimes they even relegate. And they are always difficult moments. So until now, I think in the last years, Swansea hadn't had difficult moments overall. At least on the pitch. And I think, even if it's negative now, I think it's positive. And I think it will be positive after, because I think when you come out on the other, when you've been struggling, even whatever team you are, then you appreciate, as I said that the other day, you appreciate it more what you have done and what you have. Maybe some could think that being a mid-table team without ever having to worry about even mention the name relegation, yeah, that was just for the others. It's just a fact, yeah. And I mean, we can't think about it that it's like that, you know. Clubs with many years in the Premiership, they struggle. So it's good, even if it's not so nice now. I would rather sit here and talk to you guys after I win at Old Trafford. That's much nicer. We can smile a bit more, but that's how football is.
Just, perhaps a word.
Unfortunately, we can't win always, but sometimes we'll be nicer.
Just a word on the performance of Ericsson, one of your compatriots. He was pretty impressive today.
Yeah, I think he had a good game. I think he was fantastic assist for the goal, and he had another couple of details in the first half. And I mean, he's two-footed, has a very good vision. I think that for quite a young player is not usual to see that. Great vision, and I think he's doing well, and I'm happy for him. Not that much today, but in general.
I think he must be a big plus for you, Michael. I mean, all the disappointment you have in, he is really playing well at the moment.
Who? Sorry. He's doing well, yes, and it's really he is adapting to the football here, and he's a lot more. We've seen in the last five or six games, shots on target or just wide, and a part of scoring goals. Okay, the goal today wasn't really didn't change anything, but I think in general the last five or six games, and that's good, that's positive. And better you say things like that, because you sometimes when you think everything is negative, you have to try to find the positive things. And even when things are going very well, there's always things that you're not happy with. But again, sometimes you just see dark and you won't see the lights. And he's definitely, his performance is, he's adapting to the football here, to the squad and everything. That's a light.